If you're trying to solve a linear equation that has fractions in it, then here's a tip that can really help. What you can try to do is get rid of the fractions before you even try to solve the equation. And the way you do that is you'll first find the least common multiple of all the denominators that you have, and then you'll multiply that least common multiple to the left side of the equation and the right side of the equation. And what that'll do is it'll get rid of all the fractions. It'll give you a new equation that's equivalent to the old one, but the new one won't have fractions in it. Now, we talked about least common multiples in a previous video, and one easy way that you can typically find the least common multiple is to start with the largest number, in this case 15, and write out just a few multiples of 15 or the largest number. So like 15 and 30, and then 15 more would make 45, etc. And then you start testing one at a time and see, starting with the first number, see if it's a multiple of everybody. Let's do that here. Well, 15 is a multiple of 3. 15 is a multiple of 5. And actually, 15 is a multiple of 15, of course, too. So we actually find it in the very first number. 15 would be the LCM. If 15, the first number, was not the least common multiple, then you would mark it out and you would keep going with the next number and the next number, constantly checking to see if it is a multiple of everybody. But we get kind of lucky with this example that it's our very first one. So we'll multiply 15 to the left of the equation, to the left side of the equation, and the right side of the equation. And what that will do is it will get rid of all the fractions that we have, and then we'll have an easier equation to solve. So let's see if we can do that. So here I've copied the same example down, and earlier we found that the LCM was 15 for this problem. And so we're going to multiply the left side of the equation by the LCM, 15, and the right side of the equation. All right, what we're going to do next, and this goes along with simplifying both sides of the equation, is distribute the 15 to both terms on the left. So we have 15 times x minus 4 divided by 3. Now the 15 divided by 3 part, that will give you 5. So we'll have 5 times the quantity x minus 4. And then plus, when we distribute the 15 to the 1/5, 15 divided by 5 will be 3. And that'll equal negative 2 divided by 15 times 15. And actually, those will cancel with the 15 and divided by 15 and just leave you with negative 2. All right, so look at this new equation right here. This guy right here. It looks like a brand new equation, but really it's equivalent to the previous equation that had fractions. The only benefit to this guy is he doesn't have fractions anymore, and that's a great thing. So we can proceed with solving this guy like normal, like we would typically do. We can simplify both sides as step one. So we could distribute the 5. So we'd have 5x minus 20 plus 3 equals negative 2. We can combine like terms, like the negative 20 and the 3. So we'd have 5x minus 17 equals negative 2. We can keep the variables on one side and move the constants to the other. That's one of our steps that we have to do. So we can add 17 to both sides, and we'll get plus 17, we'll get 5x equals 15, and that's negative 2 plus 17. And the last step is to divide both sides by the variable's coefficient. I'm kind of running out of space here. Divide by 5 and divide by 5. The 5s cancel, and so we get our answer of, our answer of x equals 3. That's 15 divided by 5. And so you can check this like we typically would. We can take this number and plug it back in the original equation, even the one that has fractions, and it should make the equation true. So anyways, this is how we go about solving equations that have fractions in them. We get rid of the fractions first by multiplying both sides of the equation by the least common multiple of all the denominators.